Wow. Oh my gosh. Ooh, I'm super into this, you guys. Ooh, yes! Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm super excited because, as you may know, the Sephora VIB sale was recently going on, and I personally placed an order or two, and I bought some new makeup and some new skincare, and I really, really wanted to sit down and try these out with you guys here on camera. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. I'm gonna show you guys everything that I picked up during the sale, and we're gonna put them to the test. I'm gonna try to keep it balanced, so I'm gonna use a lot of drugstore in the places where I don't have a product from Sephora that I bought. So let's jump right into it. I already did my brows off camera. I used the M Cosmetics Fine Line Brow Pencil in the shade Deep Taupe. I've already prepped my skin pretty well. I don't know if I'm gonna go in with like a proper primer today. I think I'm just gonna go straight into foundation. And I'm gonna be using the Flower Beauty Light Illusion Foundation. I like to mix these two shades. I like to mix L2 and L3. So I'm gonna do about a half a pump of each on the back of my hand. I'm gonna mix those together. And I'm gonna start to apply this foundation from the center of the face, blending it outward. And I'm gonna work in small layers because I've really been trying to wear a little bit less foundation. And I feel like half the battle for me is just applying the right amount initially. So I've been trying to take smaller amounts and really blend it out and work it into the skin before dipping into any more product. And I feel like that's helped so much. And it's just helped to keep my skin looking really natural and fresh. I'm gonna make sure to blend the foundation down the neck a little bit so we don't have a line. I'm gonna take a little bit of what's left on the back of my hand with my sponge, and I'm just gonna lightly pounce the sponge all over the face to just press the foundation in a little bit more and to make sure it's nice and seamless. It's been a minute since I've put this foundation on, and I'm obsessed with how glowy and luminous it is. I feel like this is gonna be so perfect for spring and summer makeup looks. All right, now that the foundation's blended into the skin, I'm gonna go ahead and go into a concealer. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer, and I like to take two shades, one to brighten up the under eye area and the other one to spot conceal. So I'm gonna take the shade Fair first, and I'm gonna try to practice a little bit of the less is more mentality with this and the under eye area especially. So I'm gonna put that underneath the eyes, and then let's move into the shade Light. And this is the one I'm gonna use to kind of just dot over any blemishes that I want a little bit more coverage on. The foundation did a pretty good job at evening out the skin tone, but I always like to have a little bit of extra coverage over blemishes, just like that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take my sponge and blend out the concealer on the blemishes first, and then we will blend out the concealer underneath the eyes. All right, I am loving how everything is looking. I'm just taking what's left on my sponge and running it across the eyelid just to kind of cancel out any redness there. And then we're gonna set the face using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Setting Powder. And then we will be able to hop into some of the new makeup that I bought. I've actually been really into this setting powder. It's one of the best that I've personally tried from the drugstore. I'm just gonna set the under eye area first. And then I'm gonna take a bigger fluffy brush and just go ahead and set the rest of the face. So when it came to the Sephora sale, I already had an idea of what I wanted to pick up, but I was also watching a lot of people's like Sephora VIB sale recommendation videos, and I came across Alyssa Ashley's video, and for some reason I just really wanted so many of the things she talked about, and so I picked this up because of her and that video. I'll have her channel linked down below if you don't know who she is. I love her channel. She is absolutely gorgeous, and she always has really good makeup recommendations, but I picked this up because of her. This is the Sephora Micro Smooth Powder. It's like just a baked powder. I got mine in the shade Light, and I had never really picked up anything from the Sephora brand. So I was really excited to try this. It's more of a finishing powder, if I'm understanding right, which you guys know I really love. So I'm just gonna take that same powder brush, and let's do one half of the face first to see what it does, and we can compare the two sides. So I'm just gonna take that same brush, and I'm gonna start to just buff this over everything. They have a lot of different shades, and this one seems to be working pretty well for me. As of right now, I'm not sure if I see a huge visible difference. I feel like it kind of left a little bit of a luminosity to it, but it's not as intense as, say, the Laura Mercier Candle Glow Powder or even the Milani Illuminating Translucent Powder. What do you guys think? Do you see a difference between the two sides? Let's continue and buff this on to the rest of the face. What I really like about it so far is it feels really lightweight on the skin. It doesn't feel like I'm adding a ton of powder onto the skin, even though I kind of am. It feels extremely lightweight. Okay, for some reason, after applying it to both sides of the face, I feel like I see a little bit more of a difference. It just kind of blurs everything, and it leaves a slight luminosity to the skin, but again, nothing crazy. All right, well, that's that so far. Let me know in the comments if you guys saw a difference or not. I'm not sure how visible the difference is to me personally, but I do really like how my face looks right now, so. Cool, let's move on. I also picked up the new Fenty Beauty Sunstalker Instant Warmth Bronzer. I got mine in the shade Into Sun, and I got this because a lot of people are talking about this. I think Alyssa Ashley also mentioned mentioned this in her video as well, so that's what kind of sold me finally, I guess. Here's the packaging. It's pretty and gold. They also have so many shades of this bronzer. I believe this is the lightest shade, so it'll be perfect for my fair skin, and I'm really excited to try this out. So I'm gonna take my Morphe M405 brush and dip it right into the bronzer. I love the packaging. Fenty just always has the best packaging. Then let's go ahead and kind of sculpt out the cheeks first. You guys know how I am with bronzers, and if you're new, hi, I'm Allie and I love bronzers. I feel like I'm always buying new ones. I'm always trying new ones out. And if you've been watching my videos recently, you may know that I have been really into a little bit more of a lighter bronzer, just because for me and my fair skin tone, and then also being pretty heavy-handed when it comes to bronzers, using a lighter bronzer has really helped me just keep my face looking way more natural. Ooh, but this is like showing up, but it seems to be like the perfect color for my skin. Wow. I'm gonna make sure to blend some of the bronzer down the neck as well. I'm loving how buildable this formula is. That's what I personally look for in a bronzer. A formula like that just helps you create a more seamless finish in the end when you're able to really build up the product properly without it looking muddy or being too pigmented and hard to blend out. Well, I don't know about you, but I am really loving how that made my face look. Oh my gosh. I didn't think that this bronzer would be like different than the other ones that I've been trying recently, but this shade is just like perfect for my skin tone and undertone. And again, they have so many shades of this bronzer, so no matter what skin tone you are, you'll be able to get a bronzer that gives the same effect, and you'll also be able to try the formula, obviously. Ooh, I'm super into this, you guys. So far, so good. The next thing that I picked up has been on my wish list for a while. This is the Shiseido Whipped Powder Blush, and I picked mine up in the shade Sonoya, which is a really bright, warm pink. It's way brighter than I anticipated. Look at that. I think it'll be pretty for spring and summer. I'm just gonna have to be careful with it with my fair skin to make sure that I don't overdo it. I'm gonna go ahead and dip a blush brush into the pan. This is from Flower Beauty, and I'm gonna kind of dip it and then work it into my hand first, and then I'm gonna smile and let's see how that applies. Again, I really don't want to go overboard, so bear with me if this takes me a minute to build up on the complexion, but I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of tap that over top of the cheek and kind of lift it up toward the end of the brow and up here a little bit. Sometimes I like to do that. I don't know, it just looks more fresh to me when the blush kind of travels up toward the ear a little bit. Well, I'm using the tiniest bit, so this will probably last me forever, but I'm actually really into the color. It's very pretty for spring and summer if you're into a more bright cheek. I feel like it looks nice and fresh. And it's also not grabbing at the product underneath as I apply it like this. I was kind of nervous because it's a little bit more of like a whipped formula, even though it does have a powder finish. So I was nervous putting it on top of powder, but it's working really beautifully. All right, I'm gonna leave it there. We might tone it down a little bit depending on what the rest of the makeup looks like, but I'm just gonna leave it like that for now. So far, so good, you guys. I really like how my complexion looks today. I was originally thinking that I was gonna do something more fun on the eyes, but I might keep it simple. I guess we'll decide in a second. I wanna apply highlighter next. I've had this on my wish list for so long, and then in Alyssa Ashley's video, she talked about it, and I was like, okay, if she's recommending it and I've wanted it for a long time, I'm just gonna go ahead and buy it. This is the Ciate London Dewy Sticks Luminous Highlighting Balm, and I got mine in the shade Glow, which is a little bit more of a transparent balm, if I remember right. This one doesn't have any sort of a tint to it. I think they sold a couple other colors, but I just picked this one up. In Alyssa's video, she demonstrated how she uses this, and so I'm going to copy that. I'm just gonna go ahead and take the back of my sponge and get some of this product on it, and then I'm going to just press this into the skin on the high points, and it's supposed to just give you more of like a dewy, glossy finish versus having an actual shimmery highlighter on, which really intrigued me, especially for spring and summer. That was kind of my inspiration for everything that I picked up during the sale. I just really wanted to buy things that I felt like I would use a lot in the upcoming warmer months. So, ooh, yes. Oh my gosh, I can't believe that this doesn't have like shimmer in it. I mean, maybe a little bit. It's gotta have a little bit, but it sure doesn't look like it. It just looks like my skin is so dewy. I'm assuming you could also layer this on top of a powder highlighter if you wanted that to be even more intense, but this is perfect for what I'm looking for when it comes to like a fresh looking highlight and a natural looking highlight. That's beautiful. Okay, it does have more of a sticky, balmy finish. I wonder if that will set down a little bit. Maybe not. If not, I'm not mad at that, but just something to be aware of if you end up trying this out. And that also applied on top of powder very beautifully. Wow, I love it. It looks like I didn't even put powder on my skin. All right, let's just do a quick eye look. I'm gonna take this same bronzer. I'm actually curious to see how this would work as an eyeshadow because I always use my bronzers as eyeshadows. I just feel like when I use bronzer on my eyes, especially when it's the exact same bronzer I have on my face, everything looks really cohesive, and also it's so convenient when you don't have time to grab an eyeshadow palette and you're already applying bronzer. Just like throw this in the crease and a little bit on the lid and you are good to go. I'm going to apply a little bit on the lower lash line. Okay, I think that's good for today because I have a mascara duo that I have been really wanting to try. I picked up the Marc Jacobs Velvet Primer. I have been loving the Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir Mascara for a long time, but recently I've just kind of fallen back in love with it and I've been using it quite a bit. So I bought the primer because I've really been wanting to try this, and then I've seen so many people recommend this mascara, and I've also seen Kathleen Lights recommend this combo specifically. So I really wanted to try it because I'm all about massive voluminous lashes. It's my favorite. So I picked up the Pat McGrath Fetish Eyes Mascara. I haven't opened it yet, but we're gonna apply this primer first and kind of let it dry a little bit, and then we will try out that mascara. But apparently, according to Kathleen Lights, this is a very expensive but worth it mascara combo. So I thought I would give it a try today. This primer is really interesting because it's not a stark white like a lot of primers that I've tried. It's more of like a peachy nude, which is kind of fun. I always feel like I look so weird with just lash primer on. It looks so weird. I used to think that lash primer wasn't necessary, and then I tried a L'Oreal lash primer once, and it just changed the game for me. I love them now. This, like, feels so weird, but that's the primer. Let's go ahead and open up this mascara. There's very interesting packaging on this. I'm assuming you just cut it open. I don't know. Well, too late now. All right, so here it is. Comes with a little piece of paper. Oh. Apparently this strengthens and conditions lashes over time. It's an all-in-one mascara. Ooh, okay, ready to try it. Here's the packaging. Pat McGrath always has the coolest packaging in my opinion. I've always wanted to try more of her products, but her eyeshadow palettes are so expensive. So it might take some convincing before I actually like go out and purchase one of those. Let's try this on top of the primer and see what happens. So far, I really like the brush just by looking at it. I love brushes like this. The brush seems to be a little bit more stiff than like the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara, for example. All right, so there's one eye so far. I got a ton of mascara all over my eyelid in this inner corner here, so I'm just gonna wait for that to dry and try to buff it off. But I do feel like that gave insane length and volume. And this brush also was very good at separating the lashes, considering I had a very voluminous, almost clumpy primer underneath. I feel like it did a really good job at keeping things volumized, but not like super clumpy. I made the biggest mess with this mascara on this eye especially. For some reason, it was really, really messy. It was probably just my fault, but a lot of it could have been the applicator as well. I'm gonna let this dry for a second, and then we're gonna try to buff off all of that mascara, because I really did get mascara everywhere. I feel like the same thing happens with the CoverGirl Exhibitionist mascara, and I keep wearing that mascara because I love it, but it's just like so messy, and I feel like it's just the brush shape with my eye shape that kind of gets it everywhere. While we wait for that to dry, I'm just gonna apply some lipstick. I'm gonna put on my current favorite nude from the drugstore. This is the Almay Lip Vibes lipstick in the shade Go Wild. And I'm just gonna apply that everywhere, and then I like to blend it in with my finger a little bit. And then I'm going to apply this Laneige Lip Glowy Balm on top. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I've already tried this, and as soon as I put it on my lips, I became so obsessed. I picked mine up in the shade slash flavor Grapefruit, because I love grapefruit, and it has a little bit of a pink tint to it, but it's just made my lips look so healthy and feel so hydrated. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply this on top. I've never applied it on top of a lipstick, so we'll see how that looks. I'm hoping it looks okay. So far that looks okay to me. It might be separating the lipstick formula underneath a little bit. I'm gonna leave it for a second, and we'll see if we need to change out the lipstick or not, but isn't that shine so beautiful? And it like smells and tastes so good. There's a lot of other shades that they came out with, but grapefruit is my favorite, so that's what I picked up first. I will probably end up picking up more shades. Okay, I'm trying to buff this mascara off, and it's really not buffing off the way I wanted it to. And I feel like I left it to dry for long enough, but it doesn't seem to be coming off. So I just wiped off the lip combo just because I felt like that lipstick was gonna separate throughout the day. I'm just gonna apply this alone so you guys can see the color anyway. And we'll just let that be my lipstick today. All right, I've stepped back to assess the situation and I'm gonna add a little bit more brow pencil just to kind of bring that shape back. And I normally add more bronzer. Maybe I still will, but I truly feel like the bronzer looks so nice and so natural that I really don't think I need to add as much as I normally do. The blush is nice and vibrant. That highlighter is so dewy and so glowy. My lips are glossy. I really like how everything looks. Let's go ahead and set the face today because I do want this to last as long as possible. I'm gonna use the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. I normally do like my 3-step set routine, but since this look is super casual and really hydrating already, I'm just gonna go ahead and set it with the All Nighter Spray. Take my fan. And just press everything into the skin really lightly with my sponge. You know what I do want though? I want a little bit of a highlighter in the inner corner, and this is the only one that I have sitting on my desk. This is from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Beauty Light Wand, and it's just like a cream highlighter. I'm gonna take a tiny bit of that and just apply it to the inner corner of the eye. And I'm gonna take what's left and just pop it right underneath the brow. I don't feel complete without an inner corner highlight, so I had to add that. Let's do a little bit of M Cosmetics Micro Fluff Brow Gel. I've been really into this. All right, so that is the final look. I am so in love with how healthy and dewy my complexion looks, especially. My lashes I'm really happy with as well, and the lip product too. I feel like all the makeup products that I picked up really impressed me. The only one that I'm still trying to figure out, I feel like, is this Sephora powder. With that being said, I love how my complexion looks and this contributed, so I'm gonna have to keep playing with this to see if there's other products that it might work better with or different methods that I can use, but I am excited about it. The dewy sticks, oh my gosh, I feel like that's one of my favorite things that I picked up. I feel like this and the Laneige lip balm are going to be staples this spring and summer for me because, like, who doesn't want juicy lips and glowy cheeks? Come on. I'm so excited about those. I'm really happy I picked those up. I'm pleasantly surprised at how much I loved the Fenty Beauty bronzer. I mean, I've heard good things about it, but I collect bronzers. I have so many. So deep down, I truly was like, I don't know if this is gonna be any better than all the other bronzers I've tried, especially recently, but truly, I love how this looks. It just looks like it's part of my skin, which is something that I really look for in a bronzer these days, and it's always good to have that option. So I'm really happy that I have this lighter color in my collection. I might end up picking up more depending on how tan I get this summer. I mean, I don't tan well, but I do self-tan. That's what I mean. The Shiseido blush, the littlest bit went the longest way, and I just feel like it looks like it's part of my skin as well. All these products I'm so excited about for spring. It just made my cheeks look fresh, so I'm really happy with how that worked out. The primer and the mascara, I feel like that's the thing that I'm also gonna have to keep playing with just because it was so messy, and I'm also already experiencing some flaking. I'm gonna try both of these separately, especially the primer with other mascaras, to see how I feel. I'm not mad at how my lashes look. I really like how they turned out, but I feel like it's gonna take me a couple tries to really figure out these two formulas since they are both new to me. But overall, I'm really happy with how everything turned out, especially the complexion. I love that highlighter so much, and I love this lip. I'm gonna quickly go through the skincare items that I picked up, and I also picked up a little fragrance. So I'm gonna share those with you just in case you wanted to know what other things I picked up. Obviously, with skincare items, it's gonna take me more than a first impression to kind of get my full thoughts on these products, but I thought I would share them with you anyway. The first two things I had on my wish list for a long time, and so many people love these. They have incredible reviews on Sephora's website. It's the Ulla Henriksen Balancing Force Oil Control Toner, and then also the Ulla Henriksen Glow 2O Dark Spot Toner. So I ended up picking up both because I have both concerns with my skin. I struggle with breakouts, and then I also struggle with hyperpigmentation after the breakouts. So I thought I would pick up both. Again, I haven't used these long enough yet to really see a difference, but I'm excited about them and I have high hopes for them. So that's that. I also picked up this Kate Somerville Liquid Exfoliate. It's basically like a 10% AHA treatment that you put on your skin right after cleansing and you let it sit on your skin and you don't rinse it off. And then you follow it up with the rest of your skincare and go to sleep. And then you're supposed to wake up with better skin. I've used this about 3 to 4 times. So far, so good. I haven't noticed like a significant difference yet. I feel like my skin looks a little bit more even toned in the morning, and also my pores are starting to look slightly smaller. Again, this is something that I'm gonna have to use over time to really give a proper review on it, but I am excited about it. And I like the fact that it's kind of like a leave-on treatment for nighttime. So that's that. I also picked up a couple face masks because I love to do masks. I do probably like 2 to 3 masks a week depending on what my skin needs. But this had raving reviews on Sephora's website, and I am a sucker for reviews, so I picked this up. It's the Peter Thomas Roth Therapeutic Sulfur Mask. Now, I've tried sulfur masks in the past, and apparently sulfur is so incredible for acne-prone skin especially, but my goodness, it smells bad. And it doesn't just smell funny like while it's on your skin while you're using it, but it lasts, on my skin at least, for like a day after I use it. So I was kind of unsure if I would like this. I've used this twice now, and again, it's gonna take me a little bit longer to figure out if it works for my skin. So far, so good, but I will say that there is a little bit of a sulfur scent that stays on my skin. It's not as bad as some sulfur masks that I've used in the past, but it still is there. I really like the consistency of this though. It's kind of like a more whipped, marshmallowy kind of texture. It feels good on the skin, it's really soothing, and so yeah, I picked that up too. This, I'm so excited about, and I actually used it last night for the first time, and I'm already in love. I'm definitely going to have to do more research on how to properly use this. It is the Mount Lye Rose Quartz Gua Sha Tool. So they have a jade one, but I picked up the rose quartz one because pink, and I love pink. So this basically is like a facial massage tool, and the curvature of this makes it so nice to just really sculpt and lift the jawline. Also right here, but you can also use like this side to massage your face. Again, I'm gonna have to look up like proper tutorials on how to use this, but so far, so good. I've wanted one of these for a long time. I have rose quartz rollers and I really like those, but this feels like more of an actual massage on the skin, which I love so far. So I'm so excited about that. I also picked up an overnight mask because of the reviews. This also had a lot of good reviews. This is the Youth to the People Super Berry Hydrate and Glow Dream Mask. I actually tried this out for the first time last night, and I must say that so far my skin feels so much more hydrated. Like even just applying my makeup this morning, I noticed that my skin didn't feel dry at all, and the makeup seemed to apply really nicely today. I don't know if I can credit it to this quite yet, but this is the only thing that I really did different last night. So here's what it looks like. It smells really good, and it's kind of a fun color, but basically you just apply this after cleansing and toning or whatever, and then you just put it on your skin and you sleep in it. And it's supposed to brighten up the skin and hydrate over time, so I'm excited to see how this works for me. So that's that. And then last but not least, I actually was not planning on picking this up. I had never heard of this before. I had another fragrance in mind that I wanted to try out, but as I was going through all the fragrances, some of them just didn't smell how I wanted them to on my skin. And then I sprayed this on and I immediately fell in love with it. This is from Replica. It's called Under the Lemon Trees, and it's a very fresh fragrance that has a lot of lemon in it. I personally love how this smells. It's extremely fresh, very spring and summery, which is kind of what I was looking for. My all-time favorite fragrance is the Glossier You perfume, but I kind of wanted to play around with something a little bit more light and fresh for spring and summer. I feel like this is a fragrance that you're either gonna love or hate, but for me, it smells super clean, really fresh. There's a little bit of lemon in there. And I also love how there's a spray pump on the packaging of this. So far I'm really liking it. I will keep you guys posted on whether I choose to buy the full bottle or not. But sometimes I like to try the sample first before committing to a bigger bottle because perfume is expensive. All right, you guys, that is it. I hope you enjoyed this video of me trying out my Sephora makeup that I picked up during the sale. I'm so in love with how everything turned out. Let me know in the comments below if you picked up anything from the sale and what you've tried so far and how you feel about it. I always love to know what you guys are loving. If you're new here, hi, my name is Allie and I would love for you to join the family. You can do so by hitting the subscribe button. And if you're already a subscriber but you want to be notified on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays when I upload, click on the bell after you subscribe and you'll get a notification every single time I post. That's it for today, you guys. I hope you have an amazing day wherever you are, and I will see you in my next video. Love you. Bye.